Microlecture 12, the Transatlantic Slave Trade. The Transatlantic Slave Trade is one of humanity's most important historical processes and arguably one of its biggest crimes. From the early 16th to the late 19th centuries, the forced migration of millions of human beings represents one of the most inhumane, unjust, and shameful tragedies in human history. The African victims of the trade were taken mainly to the Americas, where their presence changed the ethnic, cultural, social, and economic structure forever. European settlers first enslaved indigenous people to work on sugar plantations. When they proved ill-suited for sugar production, the Spaniards brought in Africans. For the Europeans, it seems familiar to enslave outsiders. They enslaved not only Native Americans and Africans, but also Slavic peoples from the Balkans, who often ended up working in the Eastern Mediterranean. As to why blackness became a synonym with slavery is difficult to know. It is believed it happened during the 15th century after tens of thousands of sub-Saharan Africans were forced to work as servants in the Iberian Peninsula. In pre-colonial Africa, agricultural production was low due to the quality of the soils. European and African slave traders believed that an enslaved African in America was more valuable than a free producer in Africa. The incidence of disease in the Americas also explains African enslavement. Smallpox took a terrible toll on Native Americans, and between 30 and 50% of Europeans exposed to malaria succumbed to the sickness. Africans had developed some immunity to both diseases. In the Americas, they experienced the lowest mortality rate of any people, making them the most suitable workers for the environment. The countries that led the Atlantic trade were Portugal, Holland, France, and England. Portugal practically monopolized the slave trade until the 1600s and continued to play a significant role in the 17th century. From 1690 until the British House of Commons abolished the slave trade in 1807, England was the leading African slave carrier. Several factors determined the places where slaves were captured. Among the most important ones were supply and demand conditions, sailing time to the Americas, and population density on the African coast. As the demand for slaves rose, slave traders moved down the West African coast from Senegambia to the more densely populated hinterlands of Benin and Biafra. The abundant supply of Africans to enslave in Angola, the region south of the Congo River, and the quick passage from Angola to Brazil and the Caribbean established the region as the significant coast for the slavers. Wind patterns in the Atlantic were a significant factor in determining exchange routes between Africa and the Americas. Traders naturally preferred the swiftest crossing, which is why the Portuguese carried their cargoes from Angola to Brazil and British merchants sailed from Benin to the Caribbean. The majority of enslaved Africans were intended for the sugar and coffee plantations extending from the Caribbean islands to Brazil. The so-called Middle Passage was the horrific voyage under appalling and often deadly conditions of enslaved Africans across the Atlantic to the Americas. In England, the ports of London, Bristol, and Liverpool dominated the British slave trade. In the 18th century, Liverpool was the world's greatest slave trading port. In all three cities, small and cohesive merchant classes exercised significant public influence. British ships carried textiles, gunpowder, and flint, beard and spirits, linens and woolen that they later exchanged for the enslaved people in the African trading post. European traders had two systems for exchange. One was the establishment of factory forts on the African coast. The other one was short trading, in which European ships sent boats ashore or invited African dealers to bring traders and enslaved Africans out to the vessels. The transatlantic slave trade that the British and the Dutch, Portuguese, French, Americans, and others participated in was part of a much more extensive trading network known as the Triangle Trade. European merchants sailed to Africa on the first leg of the voyage to trade European manufactured goods for enslaved people. The trip across the Atlantic on the second leg of the journey was the Middle Passage. When they reached the Americas, the merchants unload and sold their human cargoes and used the profits to purchase raw materials such as cotton, sugar, and indigo. They then transport back to Europe their load, completing the third leg of the commercial triangle. Enslaved African people had enormous impact on the economies and cultures of the Portuguese and Spanish colonies of South America and the Dutch, French, and British colonies in the Caribbean and North America. In the United States, enslaved Africans and their descendants influenced many facets of American culture, such as language, music, dance, and diet. The U.S. White House and the Congress were also built by slave labor. The importance of the slave trade extends beyond the Atlantic world. Both the expansion of capitalism and the industrialization of Western societies were related to the wealth that this trade produced. The Atlantic trade had enormous consequences for African society. The economy and the continent's technologies were well suited for the environment, but the trade disrupted the equilibrium that existed in the region. International trade did not lead to Africa's economic development. Africa experienced neither technological growth nor economic benefits in early modern times. The political consequences of the slave trade changed from place to place. The trade made some kings and warlords more powerful and rich in the short run, but promoted conditions of instability and collapse over the long run. The political and economic consequences of the African slave trade are easier to measure than the human toll taken on individual societies. The brutality of the Middle Passage and the inhumane cruelty of enslaved Africans' experience continues to affect generations of people and their descendants. This is all we have for today. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.